Hello guys, hopefully there's not too much noise from wind on the microphone. I've headed outside to do the incline test that I talked about when I reviewed the Britain's John Deere 7930, I think it is. So we're just going to do a couple of different angles here and hopefully we'll be able to see at what point the model struggles to climb the hill. So this lower piece, I've leveled that with a spirit level, so that's completely flat, and I've angled this upper piece of wood to 5 degrees to start with. So basically the only incline we should be climbing should be exactly 5 degrees on this bit of a hill. And for the first test, we have the tractor with the empty trailer just to test. It should have no problem climbing this. I have to sandpaper down to obviously give the tractor a bit of traction, and no surprise, with an empty load, tractor flew up the hill. So I'll fill the trailer now and we'll do the rest of the tests with the full trailer. Okay, so now we have the full load in the tractor. Hopefully it'll make it up the hill no problem. Oh, we're already tripping the clutch. So you can hear that noise. That's the servo saver. Our tractor is just not able to pull this load up the hill. So there we go, we've overloaded the tractor on the first incline, which is a little bit disappointing, to be honest. I was expecting it to get up this first 5 degrees incline, and this was the angle of incline that I was intending to put in my diorama in a quarry section, so obviously that's not going to work. I'll have to come up with a new idea. Now I'll expect that my models will probably climb this, but any of these models with the servo saver in them, if they can't climb it, then the diorama is not much good, because I want to be able to do this with both my models and with models that you can buy. Okay, I've changed the incline angle now. It's around about 2.5, somewhere between 2 and 3 anyway. So at 2.5, we're doing pretty well there. We got quite a bit up the hill that time, so let's just try again. Well, it got to the end, so that's not too bad. So 2.5 degrees might be just about the limit of the tractor. Getting it rolling on the angle might be a different story. Okay, so now we're at a dead stop on the incline, so it might be we had a bit of a run up from over here, so now that we're at a dead stop, it might be a little harder for the tractor to start the trailer rolling, so let's give that a go. A little bit difficult. Now this trailer is very heavy for this tractor. It's no surprise that it is tripping the thing. I was just hoping that it might make it a little bit further up the hill before it started to trip the servo saver. So on the flat, the tractor doesn't seem to have any problem pulling this full trailer. But up the incline, 5 degrees wasn't able. 2.5 was okay. So an incline of 2.5 degrees seems to be around about pretty much exactly the limit. I think the tractor was just about able to pull it up. So now that I have this set up, I'm just going to test out the John Deere 8360RT, the track tractor. It should have a lot more power and a lot more traction, so just out of interest, let's see what angle it can climb. Okay, so here's the John Deere 8360RT. We'll just start off with the 2.5 to 3 degrees angle that we had there for the other tractor, just because we're already there. So no surprise, that's no problem for the track John Deere. So let's switch to the 5 degrees. Okay, so now we're up to 5 degrees. problem there. So maybe we'll just jump straight to 10 degrees. So here we are, 10 degrees. Let's see if we can climb this one. I can hear the motors are working a little bit harder than they were, but no problem climbing. There we go. I guess we'll try 15. We're beginning to get a bit ridiculous. Okay, well here's the 15 degrees. We'll see if we can climb it. Clearly, I can hear the motor starting to struggle a bit now, but we're still pulling on. So I guess let's go for 20 degrees, and it shouldn't be able to climb that. I don't think. I'd say we've probably hit the limit. Okay, so we're at 20 degrees now. This has just gone totally ridiculous. The hitch is starting to hit the tow bar on the upper side, and the little ladder that's on the other side of the tractor, that's almost hitting the sandpaper. So if we went any higher, the ladder would just be hitting the sandpaper, wouldn't be able to climb. Anyway, let's see if it'll even pull it up this. Pulling it, but it's working hard. That's pretty impressive. We went up to 20 degrees slope. Maybe I'll put it to 25 and just start it on the incline and see if we can climb it then. Okay, well, now we're at 25 degrees. This will be the last test, just to see if it can even pull it up this at all. And amazingly, the tracks are spinning on the sandpaper. That's how hard it is to pull up this. No way we're going to be able to climb this. So there you go. Just out of interest, let's see, can climb it without the trailer, and no problem at all. It's not terribly surprising really, not pulling a huge amount of load with just the tractor, well compared to the fully loaded trailer anyway. There you have it, that's a pretty incline test. It looks like 2.5 degrees is steep enough for normal tractors. 20 degrees seems to be the stopping point for this tractor pulling a full load. So I guess when you're doing your diorama, you'd want to stick to under 2.5 degrees if you're planning to pull heavy loads up through the up the incline. So heavy loads of gravel or maybe sand and stuff like that. If you're going to be carrying heavy loads, you probably want to stick to under 2.5 just to make sure that every tractor that's going to be on your diorama can climb it. For normal stuff, you shouldn't really have this problem. I'd say 5 or 10 degrees incline is probably going to be fine when you're just pulling normal stuff, any kind of plows or anything like that. They're all fairly light, you shouldn't have much trouble pulling them sort of things around, so should be fine. So that's the incline test video. If you like that, make sure and hit the like button, and if you have any comments or suggestions, let me know. So that's pretty much all there is to this, so thank you very much for watching. Track here.